Prior to humans using coins as currency, they'd barter for things, such as tools used for hunting. But eventually, it just made sense to create something used as a unit of value, instead of lugging around all your belongings anytime you wanted to trade. Back in the day, and we mean many thousands of years ago, that form of currency might have been shells, beads, or amber. Then the Mesopotamians around 5,000 years ago created the first coin, known as the Mesopotamian shekel. In time, we had debt, taxes, and anyone with lots of these coins could gain great power by paying for armies. Cash could provide well-being, and it could encourage a man to kill his own brother. Money makes the world go round, but in some ways it's still pretty cheap. Let us explain. We carry this stuff around with us almost all the time, but we don't usually think about where it comes from. Money gets a raw deal, really, because we just don't care about its past. We only care about what it can get us. It's a very selfish relationship we have with money. We earn it and then we give it to someone else and never think once about its history. Well, it's actually quite special, this thing called money. It's not easy to make and a lot of expertise and labor goes into producing it. Otherwise, we'd all be printing money and making coins in our own backyard. It's gotta be perfect. And in the USA, the Bureau of Engraving and Printing makes sure that cash is just that. This takes many man hours, lots of modern machines, and meticulous quality control. Let's first look at how bills are made in the US. The special paper that bills are printed on is made of 75% cotton and 25% linen. This is different from the paper you ordinarily use, which is made from wood pulp. According to the US Department of the Treasury, any denomination of 5 bucks and above has a security thread already built into that paper. With the $100 note, it's a bit different, as it has a 6mm wide 3D security ribbon woven into the paper. For good reason, these things should be hard to forge, but it's happened, and we'll come to that. The money then needs printing, and that happens on large sheets. Each bill isn't individually printed. Using large metal plates, the bill is engraved with the design. So in this case, you'd expect each bill to cost about the same from manufacturing except the $100 bill, which is slightly different, as well as the $1 and $2 bills, which don't have the security thread built into them. This is what the US Treasury writes about the inks used to make the bills. All bills, regardless of denomination, utilize green ink on the backs. Faces, on the other hand, use black ink. Color-shifting ink in the lower right-hand corner for the $10 denominations and higher, and the metallic ink for the freedom icons on redesigned $10, $20, and $50 bills. The $100 notes' bell in the inkwell freedom icon uses color-shifting ink. These and other inks appearing in US currency are specially formulated and blended by the BEP. Inks headed for BEP presses also undergo continual quality testing. As you can see, making money is hard work. Counterfeiters struggle to make money like the experts do, but on occasion, people have done a pretty good job. You might have heard of something called the Super Dollar, which the US government states is an almost perfect counterfeit $100 bill, created possibly by another government. What happens is detection technology gets better, but then the counterfeiters also get better and create more of these supernotes. It's a cat-and-mouse game, and that's why money printers have to be on top of their game. Some counterfeiters get away with it for a while, with one big case involving a bunch of British criminals who were making almost perfect dollars and pounds until they got caught in 2005. These guys were literally printing cash to the tune of £1 million and $500,000 a day. Now that's how to get rich quick. And these guys were experts in printing money. They weren't the first and they won't be the last, so let's just say that money-making technology costs countries a fair bit of money. With that in mind, if you were to ask the Treasury Department just how much it costs to make money, they'd tell you it's about much more than just buying raw materials and fashioning the cash. If you look at the 2019 currency operating budget, you'll find that it is $955.8 million. We actually looked at the budget breakdown and found that $210 million went to the Bureau of Engraving and Printing to cover facilities costs and expansion at Fort Worth, Texas. The other big printing place is in Washington, D.C. Lots more cash goes toward research and development and automated counterfeit inspection. Then you've got operating costs, which includes printing the stuff and running the machines. You've also got the board to pay and all the staff to pay. You've got security and transportation, and with cash, you need to do that right. That's why part of the budget goes to armored carrier contracts. But in the end, the main part of the budget goes toward printing. How fast can they make money? Well, it's said the printing machines can print around 8,000 sheets an hour. Most of this process is automated, but humans will do the quality control part. The bills are not just looked at by humans either. They're also put through scanners, which can detect the slightest fault. If they make the grade, the big sheets are stacked in piles of 10, and then it's time to cut them to make individual bills. These are then separated again and then made into bricks. These bricks are given a barcode, and then they're ready to be shipped all over the USA. You might be the guy whose job it is to move the pallets around that contain the boxes of bricks. It might be quite the frustrating job if you're low paid and surrounded by tons of cash all day. You can actually find reports of people stealing cash, sometimes a lot of cash, but then getting caught. One guy was arrested after it was found he'd been hiding money inside the bathroom walls. At the time, a special agent told the press that the Bureau of Engraving and Printing is the worst place you can try to steal money because people just never get away with it. We went to the Bureau of Engraving and Printing website and looked to see how much people who worked at the facilities are paid. There are so many jobs you can do, we can't really go into them all, but we looked at various grades and steps for employees. If you're grade 1 in step 1, you'll get paid $24,633 a year. Grade 15 in step 10, and you'll get $166,500. You could be pulling pallets around or you could be sat on the board. You could be designing the latest detection technology or working as a secretary. But this all goes toward the cost of making cash. Okay, so we had to tell you all of that to give you an idea of costs. But there's also a printing cost for that cash, and thankfully, the Federal Reserve has published the 2019 cost. Here it is. To print $1 or $2, it costs 5.5 cents a note. To print $5, it costs 11.4 cents. $10 costs 11.1 cents, and $20 costs 11.5 cents. $50 costs 11.5 cents too, and $100 comes in at 14.2 cents. As for coins, they're made at 6 locations in the USA. Unlike notes, coins are not as good value for the money. The price of making coins went up in 2018 thanks to metal prices increasing. In case you didn't know, the quarter, nickel, and dime coins are a copper-nickel combination. Pennies are copper-plated zinc. According to the Mint, making 1 cent from start to finish and getting it out costs 2.06 cents in 2018. So it cost more than it was actually worth. In fact, one headline in 2019 read, "The US Mint lost $69 million making pennies last year." Around $20 million was lost on making nickels, which cost 6.6 cents to make. But the rest of the coins did make the Mint some cash, because dimes cost 3.33 cents to make and quarters cost 8.24 cents to make. You could almost say that when you have a quarter, you don't just have the biggest coin, but you also have the most profitable coin. Your pennies are dead in the water. You may as well throw them in the next fountain you see. Over in the UK, they have those nice-looking 1-pound and 2-pound coins, and even the commemorative 5-pound coin. We tried to find out how much it costs to make these pretty things, but found this message on the Royal Mint's website. The Royal Mint does not reveal exactly how much it costs to make specific coins, as such information could be used in its competitors' advantage. People have tried to work out how much it costs to make a pound and have come up with around 4 pence, about 5 cents. But we can't say that this is what it costs for sure. The same goes for making British currency bills. We can't find the exact cost as it's not published. We do know that when the new polymer notes were introduced, that change cost a lot of money, as it required new machinery and new technologies. But the Bank of England said it would soon make that money back because those notes last a lot longer than the old ones. You might be thinking that these new plastic notes are harder to counterfeit, but we found a lot of reports suggesting that this might not actually be the case. Australia, for example, used to have low forgery rates after the polymer bills were introduced. But reports in 2018 said forgers were back at it again. It's the same in the UK. The new notes were supposed to be impossible to counterfeit, but that hasn't stopped people trying. Reports tell us that indeed dodgy 5 and 10 pound notes have been found in circulation, but apparently anyone with a keen eye should be able to spot them. People have even been forging a polymer 20 pound note, and that isn't even out yet. As for counterfeiting coins, euros have been plagued by forging for some time. While back in 2014 in the UK, it was revealed that just over 3% of pound coins in circulation were counterfeits. Because of that, new pound coins had to be introduced that were much harder to forge. In fact, it said UK pound coins are some of the most counterfeited money in the world. But then, US bills are also up there as some of the most forged currency in the world. Other currencies plagued by counterfeits are the euro, the Chinese yuan, and the Indian rupee. So now you know how much money costs. Should we all switch to electronic currency? Let us know in the comments. Also, don't forget to watch our other video, "Why Does Each US Air Force Pilot Helmet Cost $400,000? Thanks for watching, and as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time.